gonna take you back to the past to play the shitty games that suck ass. He'd rather have a buffalo, take a diarrhea dump in his ear. He'd rather eat the rotten asshole of a roadkill skunk and down it with beer. He's the angriest gamer you've ever heard. He's the angry Nintendo nerd. He's the angry Nintendo nerd.
No. No.
You like Nintendo? You like to play shitty games?
No.
You fucking nerd. You wanna play some Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde?
No. No.
Or you wanna play my game, bitch? Ha ha ha!
This game's horrible.
This game is my fucking nightmare. It's a frustrating, incoherent pile of vomited shit. Even the first screen is kind of weird because it shows Freddy without his glove, but his knives are still coming out of the fingers. Now, I think I might actually have an explanation for this. In the movie, Nightmare Part 2, they just fucked up. So you play as some dude who has some serious balls because he punches snakes right in the fucking face. And you don't have to anyway, you just jump over them all. So this guy has the worst luck ever because rocks randomly fall out of the sky and flocks of vampire bats come after him. Even though it may appear to be a typical side-scroller, it isn't at all. There's nothing self-explanatory or even fun about this diarrhea mess. I can't figure out where I'm supposed to go. Some of the doors are closed and some of them are open, but it hardly seems to matter because usually there's only one on the entire street that you can go inside. Whether it's open or shut, it seems completely fucking random.
Ha! Figure that out!
So you go inside one of the houses, and guess what? It's crawling with ginormous spiders. So what do? You give them a taste of your fist. Punch them! Smack them around! Assholes! Goddamn fucking spiders! Eat my ass, you fucking bitches! Show me you're a man! Punch those spiders!
Spiders! Punch them! Snakes! You want some too?
So I get to this little square door on the floor, and I can't go down. The arrow says down, which probably means that's where I'm supposed to go, but I can't. It's not till later I find out I'm supposed to collect all the bones in this room first. When I first started playing this, I had no clue what they were for, but now I realize you have to get the bones because that's the point of the game. And if you can't find every single last one of them, you can't leave the room. And some of them are practically invisible. They blend in with the background because the graphics just suck.
Ooh, yeah! Play that shitty game!
The plot of this game is that you're trying to collect all of Freddy's bones so you can destroy them in a furnace. Confused? Well, Freddy's dead, and now his bones are somehow scattered all around every house on Elm Street. Meanwhile, Freddy's entering your dreams, just like in the movies, and he can only be stopped when his final remains no longer exist. Damn, Freddy's got a lot of fucking bones! And they all look exactly the same. Classic cartoon dog bone. You know, come to think of it, the plot's kinda like Simon's Quest. Why would Simon want to go around collecting pieces of Dracula? He was killed the first time, just leave him alone. Imagine if Batman killed the Joker and then he scattered his pieces all over the fucking city and then went around collecting them all. What a bunch of fucking shit. In fact, the gameplay in Nightmare on Elm Street itself is a lot like Simon's Quest. It has that strange presence to it, where you slip in and out of day to night. In this case, it's a dream world and a awake world. It's got that non-linear quality to it where you're always confused trying to figure out where the fuck to go.
Ah, taste the major suckage, you fucking nerd!
So at the end of each house, some weird incarnation of Freddy appears. In this part, it's Freddy's hand on a bunch of balls. What were they thinking? So, you go around looking for another house you can go in, and none of them let me in. Try the cemetery? Nope, can't go there. What's with the zombies? They look like Frankenstein monsters walking with their arms stretched out. Like, how fucking stereotypical is that? Can I go in the junkyard? Nope. Just keep walking around. Walking down, I guess it's Elm Street, which happens to be the longest fucking street in the world. Oh look, I finally found a house I can go in. The one with the door that's shut. That makes sense, right? What the fuck are these? Lollipop ghosts with stick arms? Were the enemies in this game designed by some kindergarten kid for Halloween? I'm surprised they don't have skeletons too. They actually do have skeletons. What the fuck? Could the villains be any more stock? Like, we had this creepy game about Freddy. What kind of creepy characters could we add? Well, how about bats, ghosts, spiders, skeletons, and Frankensteins for the kiddies? Could it be any more uncreative than that? Like, why don't they just add some witches, black cats, and flying jack-o'-lanterns? They should have just called the game Boo, Haunted House, which is probably what they originally had in mind until they thought, no, wait, make it about Freddy. We already ruined Friday the 13th, now let's do the same thing to Nightmare on Elm Street. And that's right, it's by the same company. We're not gonna say who it is, but it stands for Laughing, Joking, Numbnuts. Also, listen to the music. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? In fact, it sounds kinda like it's recycled from Who the Fuck Framed Roger Rabbit, another piece of garbage they made. What were they thinking?
You love it, you know you do.
So let me explain how the dream world thing works. You have a sleep meter that goes down. If you're standing still, it goes down. If you get hit, it goes down. And in time, it goes down by itself. So anything you do or don't do, the sleep meter goes down.
Ain't that a bitch?
And once it's down all the way, you go to sleep. Unless you didn't already fall asleep playing this fucking game. So when you're in the dream world, all the enemies are stronger. Which doesn't even matter anyway, because you can turn into this other character that throws javelins and does the spinning jump. There's also other dream characters you can play as after you collect the dream tokens. Just like in the movie Nightmare Part 3. Except for the dream tokens part. So if you play in the dream world for a lengthy period of time, the Freddy music starts playing. Then, oh god, is Freddy coming? He sure is! Of all the shitty things in this game, this screen is so cheesy that it's just awesome. But it's ruined by the fucking trademark symbol. Anyway, you fight Freddy, which turns out to be real disappointing. It's just a simple flat room and he walks back and forth, swatting at the air like he's blind. Come on, Freddy. To get out of the dream world, you have to get the radio to wake yourself up. Then you have to wait for it to change back to the awake world. It's annoying like in Simon's Quest, but in Simon's Quest it's way worse because it's against your own will, it happens so often, and you don't expect it. In Nightmare on Elm Street, at least you're doing it on purpose and you get that rockin' tune rather than just dead silence. But now, I'm using my fists again. Give me the javelin back. I want to go back to sleep. You actually have weapons in the dream world, so what's the point? You know what's really weird? That this game was actually capable of a four-player mode using an accessory that allowed four controllers to be connected to your Nintendo Entertainment System. Now, I can't imagine having four people playing this game. Who's going to want to play this piece of shit? I'm lucky if I can get one other person. I have a better chance of cloning myself.
This game is so fucking
this is shit.
It's so fucking
shit.
This game is horrible.
Fuck
some diarrhea.
Fuck
asshole. Sucks
fuck shit.
Sucks.
It balls.
What a piece
what
of
a
shit.
Shitload of fuck.
What a piece
hey, wait,
of fucking
wait,
shit.
Wait, wait, wait. I just cloned myself. I'm in a dream. I can do whatever I want. So why don't we all just stop playing this fucking game?
Yeah.
So the hell with that shit. Yeah. The hell with that damn shit. The hell with that damn fucking shit. The hell with that goddamn motherfucking bullshit. Relax.
Now what should we do with the cartridge?
How about smash it with the hammer?
Nah, that's not good enough.
I know, let's drop it out the window.
Now come on, be creative.
I say we take a shit on it.
Good, do it. Empty your ass all over it.
I don't gotta take a shit though, you take a shit.
You gotta take a shit? Who's gotta take a shit?
I gotta take a shit.
Then take that shit!
Bombs away!
Oh, fuck you diarrhea fiend!
Whoa, hey.
Whoa.
Come on, it's not that bad. Front door, closet. Front door, closet.
Shit! Buffalo diarrhea fuck farts! You see, nerd, nobody makes you play these games but yourself. So you're your own damn nightmare. Now, you're gonna die.
Go yank your cock through your ass, you fucking butt mongrel! I got the power glove!
That was a weird dream.